can easily change the project to any panel in the Seymour Micro family at any time, either from the Navigation Windows Function tab, Panel Manager, or from the Setup menu, Panel Manager. From there, you can select the panel you want. If you originally set the panel up as a 3-inch panel like we did here, and then switch to a larger panel, let's say a 4-inch panel like this one, when you hit OK, the software will ask you if you want to display the screens as original size or scale all the objects to the new size. Usually, you'll want to leave it at the original size. For this example, let's tell it to scale the objects to the new resolution so they appear the same size as before relative to the panel. Now we have our new 4-inch panel with all the objects scaled up to appear to be the same size as before. Can we go back to the 3-inch panel? Sure. Bring up the Panel Manager. Change it back to the 3-inch panel we had before. Say OK. We are going to adjust the screen resolution back to the 3-inch size. And here's our 3-inch panel just like we had it. This time, let's go to the 4-inch panel. But let's not scale everything up. Let's leave everything at its original size. Now the objects are at the 3-inch size, and you have a lot more panel area to work with. That's because even though the 4-inch panel is only a little bigger physically, it's much bigger from a screen resolution standpoint because it has over 9 times the pixels as the 3-inch panel does. And of course, we can use color with the larger panels too. One side note, if you start on a larger panel and then try to reduce it to a smaller panel, things might not work out so clean. For example, if we start with a busy 4-inch panel like this, I just copied our 3-inch objects and spread them all over the screen, then we try to go to a 3-inch panel, and we adjust them so that they fit the new panel, we just get a mess. So be sure to plan ahead. If you think you're going to use a 3-inch panel, try and set up your layout for a 3-inch panel. Well, that's it for swapping panel types. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.